In this Q&A video, we're going to answer the question, why is it that LED fittings rely on red, green and blue LEDs to make different colours instead of red, yellow and blue? This question relates to our free training package to help with your CPD that we've made with BG Luceco on the subject of smart home systems. It's completely free, fully certificated by CPD UK. You can take it at any time, and upon successful completion, you'll receive a certificate and be able to count an hour towards your annual CPD requirement. You'll find this over on eFIXX.co.uk under the know-how tab or at lucecoacademy.com under the courses tab. However, let's answer this question now. Looking at the packaging for this smart light fitting, you can see that you've got the letters RGB on there. Now that stands for red, green and blue. And it means that the light source can be used to create different colours by combining the output from red, green and blue LEDs within the fitting. Now it may seem a little odd that this is red, green and blue and not the classic primary colours red, yellow and blue that we learnt at school as being the ones that make up all the other colours. Now, this is because, as is often the case, you only get half the story while you're at school. Red, yellow and blue are what's called a subtractive colour model. In other words, the more you add together the combinations of colours, the darker the colour becomes. I'm sure, like me, when you used to combine all the colour paints at school, you were kind of bemused by the greenish muddy mess that you'd get, only to go next door to your science class and be told that all the colours combined together give you white. Well, let's demonstrate what happens with these poster paints and this canvas, and I'm going to go into full Bob Ross mode here. Hello and welcome to this episode of The Joy of Electrical. What we're going to be doing in this video is we're going to be looking at what happens when we combine the primary colours, red, yellow and blue. So we've got our happy little colours on the palette here, and we're going to be using these to create some artwork on the canvas behind me. What we're going to do, we're going to start off with some royal red here. So we'll get this red, and look at that. You just want to dab it on the brush there, and you just want to then gently stroke it onto the canvas like that. And you can see there we've got that lovely bright red. Now what we don't want to do is start mixing up our colours straight away. So what we're going to do is we're going to take another brush. We're going to take our jasmine yellow, and we're going to get that really deep into the bristles, and we're going to create a new patch of colour there. Look at this. Look at that, isn't that beautiful? It just makes me happy just seeing that on the screen there. And that's the important thing to remember about painting, is that it doesn't matter what anyone thinks about it or what anybody does about it. It's just about you and enjoying yourself. Now we'll get some of this midnight blue here. And there's our fourth square there. And those are our three primary colors, as you can see. Aren't they beautiful? Don't they just make you happy? Now, we all know what happens when we start to combine these colours. What we're going to do is we're going to take our blue and our yellow, and we're going to mix those together. So we'll take a little bit of the blue, and we'll take a little bit of the yellow, and then we're going to mix them up real good there. And you see what happens there? Look at that. Instantly the colour starts to get darker, and you've got this beautiful turquoisey green colour right there. So we mix that up. We mix that up real good, and then we introduce that to the canvas. And as you can see, we've got this beautiful deep green. Look at that beautiful colour there. Deep green colour. Makes me happy. Makes me think of childhoods by the sea, enjoying our youth. But now look what's happened when we bring in the red here as well. So we'll get a big blob of the red and we'll mix that in. And look what happens now. We get this absolutely hideous, brownish, reddish mess here. And when we whack that onto the canvas, you can see it's just got darker and darker and darker the more colours that we've combined. And that's what we mean by a subtractive colour system. It gets darker the more colours you add. And it's nice to see we've not made any mistakes on here, because we don't have mistakes. What we have are happy little accidents. Now, when it comes to lighting, we use RGB, or red, green and blue, and that's what's referred to as an additive colour model, which means that the more you mix them together, the lighter the colour gets. Let's demonstrate that here using these fittings from BG Luceco. Okay, so we've set up the different lamps and fittings from BG Luceco on the bench here, and we've just wired them up with some temporary connections, and we're going to use these to demonstrate this principle of an additive colour model using the red, green and blue LEDs. Now it's really important to note that each of these fittings can achieve that colour changing effect by themselves with the red, green and blue LEDs that are inside them, However, here we're just using these as solid individual colours to demonstrate the principle. So what I'm going to do first of all is turn on the pendant style lamp, and that's giving off this bright red colour onto the surface of the canvas, which I painted my masterpiece on earlier, you may remember. Now, if I turn that one off and I bring up the recessed style fitting that is purely green, you can see there that's giving off this really deep, bright green colour there, you can see. And now if I switch that one off and bring up the blue light source, you can see there that deep blue colour there. However, if I now bring the pendant back up, you can see that the blue and the red light source, when the light combines and hits the surface, creates this kind of purpley effect here. And that's because we've added those two colours together to create that slightly brighter colour effect there. However, if we now bring in the green light source as well, you can see now we've created this white light source here. So those three lights combine their colours to give a white light. And that is the principle behind an additive colour model. The reason that these two models behave differently is that when you paint red, yellow and blue colours onto a surface, they absorb and reflect different wavelengths of light. The painted surface is not a light source in itself. However, when you turn on a light with red, green and blue LEDs inside, it's actually giving off light. So by turning the LEDs up and down to different brightnesses, you can get an almost endless variety of colours emanating from the fitting. So there we go. Simply put, when adding colour to a surface, we use a subtractive colour model of red, yellow and blue, because the colours on the surface reflect and absorb different wavelengths of light. But when we adjust a light source to change the colour output, we use an additive colour model because the fitting is generating the light we see by. For more detailed information like this on different aspects of smart home systems, please click the link either in the description below or just head over to the know-how tab over at eFIXX.co.uk or lucecoacademy.com under the courses tab. And as always, we want to hear from you. Were you aware that you'd been underinformed at school about colour models? Do you incorporate colour changing LED technology into your installations? Whatever the case, please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.